Leeds Rhinos out first. to a big reception from a lot of Leeds fans on that far side that made the short journey from Headingley to see their team take on the Halifax Blue Sox. Blue Sox 4 defeats under Steve Linnane. But it has to be said, the rugby has been very attractive, and the four games that could quite easily have won, certainly the ones against Warrington and Castleford, but Leeds under Daryl Powell, getting one or two of their injured stars back. His first game was a nightmare when the Rhinos got absolutely hammered at Warrington. Leeds team tonight is Francis Cummins, Mark Calderwood, Tony Carroll and Keith Senior. Marcus Saint-Hilaire are the backs, the half-backs are Yestin Harris and Carl Pratt, no Ryan Sheridan. Darren Fleary, Robbie Mees, Jamie Matthew at the front row, Andy Hay, Anthony Farrell and Kevin Sinfield, the back three of the lead six, and on the bench, Barry McDermott, Bradley Clyde, Chev Walker and Robert Burrow. And Leeds made to wait till Halifax finally make their appearance. The one plus thing for Halifax is that Leeds, of course, have never won at the Shay. And the fact that Halifax game has improved over the last 4 weeks, Steve Linnane will be hopeful of that first win this evening. Daryl Cardis drops back to full-back. Damien Gibson, Stuart Donlan, Danny Tickle and Ollie Marnes are three quarters. Quite a task for Stuart Donlan and Danny Tickle, stopping the likes of Tony Carroll and Keith Senior. Dean Lawford and Gavin Clinton are the three quarters. Brett Goldspink, John Lawless, Jim Gannon the front row, Shane McMenemy, Paul Davidson, Martin Moana, the back three of the Halifax pack, Sean Penkovic, Andy Hobson, Jamie Blue and Adam Hughes on the bench for Halifax. Adam Hughes having to leave the game at Castleford for personal reasons. And Steve Linnane said he's about to play in this game. Gavin Clinch, who was only running at 90% yesterday, declared himself fit this morning. Could hardly walk by all accounts yesterday, such was the swelling on his knee, but he's kicked off. And Leeds come away with the first set of six with Fleary, brought down 22 metres out. Scrappy at the play of the ball. Jamie Matthew making one of his rare starts for the Leeds Rhinos. Now Anthony Farrell, who takes high one from Shane McMenemy. Ian Smith, the referee, who got a good report from Andrew Dunham when he refereed Halifax at the Boulevard a couple of weeks ago. As Marnes picks it up in defence, first man there, Matthew, but Farrell also there to bring the winger down 12 metres away from the Halifax line. Damien Gibson, former Leeds player. And so is Dean Lawford, of course, released by Leeds a couple of weeks ago, looking to put one over on his old employers. Came on at Castleford and did a good job. Perhaps was just a bit short of match fitness, as Goldspink almost had the pass away there, but didn't catch the ball correctly. Now back to Clinch. Left by, or caught by Fleary. Cardis looks for a gap. Clinch again. Dabbing one over for the 40-20. And Calderwood and Cummins get to it. And Cummins looked to touch that with his hand. Calderwood a bit slow to react. I think Cummins had to tell him that that was looking like a 40-20. So a good start from Clinch as Calderwood soon goes down when he sees Moana and Davidson in front of him. Andy Hay out to Senior. Well marked by Tickle on his opening run. Now Andy Hay into Clinch and Moana, 3 metres from halfway, but the penalty given. Well, it looked as though Andy Hay dropped that ball, but Moana and Clinch, both men in there. Ian Smith, no hesitation in giving the penalty to the Leeds Rhinos. And Harris drops one into touch on the Halifax 20 to set up the first real attack for the Leeds Rhinos. Matthew goes the dummy runner. Pratt gives it to Fleary. Davidson and Fleary messing about the play of the ball. Harris bringing Tony Carroll on the inside. And such strength, it takes three Halifax men to bring him down. Cardis, McMenemy and Gannon. Now Farrell, followed by Lawford, gets it away, despite the attentions of Donnellan, and Calderwood goes for the gap, and he's almost over the Halifax line. They just managed to hold him up. In fact, they've held him up over the line, and I think the Halifax supporters are saying he didn't reach it. Well, he certainly didn't look to have gone over from here. So Leeds will get the scrum and six more to attack the Halifax line. Sinfield up from the back to Pratt, out to Cummins, Cummins to Senior. Senior well tackled again by Danny Tickle. Watch closely. Sent Hilaire up from acting half, disappearing under three. 5 metres away from the Halifax line. Halifax need to regroup quickly, could be stretched in defence. Matthew with the dummy and the sidestep. Harris, Halifax lacking out wide, but he's invited Farrell back on the run on the inside. And Halifax having trouble putting Farrell down. They're kicking out there at Gavin Clint. Harris puts it round the back to Cummins, and the screams of a forward pass from Gavin Clint and the Halifax supporters, but Ian Smith nor the officials have noticed that one, so Leeds will get the first points. Screams of a forward pass, both from the Halifax scrum half and the Halifax supporters at the back of those posts. There are five officials. None of them seeing it, so Cummins allowed to go through and put first points on the board for Leeds. But Halifax already had complaint when it looked as though Calderwood hadn't got over the line. Perhaps it was Halifax players with the tackle that had dragged him over, which set up the scrum. And Leeds using the full width of the field to good advantage. Firstly stretching Halifax, pulling back into the middle. And then moving it out wide to come for Cummins to score. As Justin Harris finds the mark from 5 yards in from the touchline. And the Leeds Rhinos lead Halifax Blue Sox by 6 points to nil. So Gavin Clint will kick off again for the Blue Sox. Halifax giving away early points, 7 minutes gone. Carl Pratt inside to Andy Hay, but the chase is there for the Blue Sox. The tackle made on the 20. Davidson and Lawless. Fleer it into Goldspink and Gannon. And Lawless there for good measure as well. Lee still going with the forwards with Matthew into McMenemy and Davidson. Goldspink also there. Halifax using three men in the tackle. Farrell coming up off the pass from Robbie Mears. Halifax forwards are there to tackle again. Lawless and Davidson just inside the Halifax half as Mears goes from acting half. Leeds with numbers on that far side. Andy A takes the pass, and the screams again of a forward pass. Last tackle being given. Ian Smith raises his hand in the air. Back to Harris. Drops one right near the Halifax line. Cardis goes up for it. Comes backwards to Gannon. But Gannon is immediately swamped by three. Already waiting as the ball came down. Now Cardis from acting half. Trying to duck under Carl Pratt. Damien Gibson into Calderwood and Carroll. Lawford to McMenemy. High shot from Matthew. Fleury there as well. Goldspink, risky ball to Gannon. Did well to keep hold of it. Clinch again, looking for the 40-20, come off the wrong side of the foot though. Bounces up nicely for Calderwood, who sends coming off one way and goes to the centre field. Lawless and Clinch waiting. Sinfield from acting half to Saint Hilaire. who Clinch manages to keep hold of by the shorts until Lawless finishes the job off. 10 metres from halfway. Fleeret out to Tony Carroll, pushes away Lawford, gets round Donlan. Lawford has another go, makes a good tackle with Gibson round the top. Halifax struggling for possession at the moment as Lawford hits Matthew to slow him down, and Gannon and Davidson finish him off on the Halifax 40. And this time the knock-on's been spotted by Jamie Matthew. Can't believe it. Says he was interfered with as he played the ball. And so Halifax will finally get to see the football just inside their own 40 with Clinch to feed the scrum. Switches it back to Cardis, but the cover's there to take Cardis in the shape of Cummins and Carroll. McMenemy running strongly, Sinfield going upstairs. And McMenemy might have gone through had there not been a bit of help from Robbie Mears there. But Ian Smith gives the Blue Sox a penalty. The 40 metres out. Martin Moana decides that Danny Tickle should go for goal. Danny Tickle and Jamie Bloom out before this game again, practicing kicking. Along with one or two other Halifax players who were practicing the high kicks. But Halifax not had sufficient possession to put any of those into practice yet. And certainly not in the least quarter of the field anyway. So Danny Tickle hoping to take the 2 points on offer to put first points on the board for the Blue Sox. Great cheer went up as Leeds were caught offside. Tickle from 40 metres, pulls it round perfectly, and the Blue Sox off the mark with that penalty after Leeds. An indiscretion, and the Blue Sox will of course get the ball back from the kickoff. Ideal conditions this evening at the Shay. Pitch one or two wet patches on it where there's no grass. Other than that, the conditions and the temperature. And Harris has immediately put Leeds on the offensive again, finding a gap between the three Halifax players on that far side. And Halifax won't get the ball from the kickoff. They'll find themselves defending again close to their own line. In a position adjacent to that which Leeds scored from earlier when Cummins went over. Harris to Cummins, Donlan tracking Cummins all the way. Brought down a bit easier than Tony Carroll was as Farrell gets to the 10 for Leeds and is brought down by three, but Halifax looking light on that left-hand side again. Carl Pratt, Matthew to Fleeret. Shouts for forward pass again. Halifax still light on that left-hand side. Now they move it out. Harris bringing the ball back on the inside. Cummins brought down, taking off Sinfield's pass. And Leeds still have men on that left-hand side. Harris, long ball out to Keith Senior, but well tackled. A metre short of the line, Gavin Clinch there. Halifax out quickly as Harris is allowed to chip it through on the floor. Lawford picks it up, skips away from one. Well, he got away from Farrell, couldn't get away from Fleary. Plays it quickly, though. Donlan. Playing safety rugby. Had Marnes on his outside. Marnes will go from acting half to Goldspink. And Goldspink into Harris and Mears. Now Lawless. Running straight at Harris. Goldspink to Davidson. And Davidson shovels one out the back somehow. Now Danny Tickle out to Marnes. Marnes a foot race against Senior. But Senior always had the upper hand there because Marnes was on the touchline and wasn't going to take that option. Clinch drops one back towards Calderwood again, and Calderwood takes it on the 20, and Halifax will have to be wary of the speed of this winger, given the space. Well, Moana's penalised there unjustly, as Calderwood was kicking out and kicking out, and Moana couldn't get his hands away. So Leeds another penalty. Fleury with the first run. Halifax on the back foot again. And Sinfield dropped the ball. And McMenemy's taking a high shot there off Fleury, and he's still giving him a face. Oh, it's Farrell. Gibson running from acting half. Halifax know only too well the troubles of having to defend two sets of six tackles. Tony Carroll all over Gibson. Davidson off the short ball. Halifax knowing the perils of defending two sets of six, as they conceded three tries at Weldon Road in that from that very position. And there's a few high shots going in. Fleury's thrown one then. Matthew all over Goldspink. Clinch out to Lawford. Lawford to McMenemy. Big it from Carroll. Gives it to Gannon. Gannon will drive forward into Sinfield and Pratt. Just short of halfway. Moana in quickly acting half. Clinch. A little chip through. Well, he's chased it himself, but Hilaire, if he gets away, could have a chance. Good job he didn't pass the ball then, because Marnes had come back for the intercept. Senior will run at Marnes. Unsuccessfully, Davidson finishes it off. Senior and Davidson having a bit of a tete-a-tete on that far side, as Matthew is allowed to run. But Leeds with all the pressure in the opening 15 minutes of this game. And through goes Robbie Mears. Cardis won't catch him. Halifax defended for most of the first 15 minutes and eventually succumbing to the pressure of Robbie Mears darting away from the acting half position, putting a second try on the score for Leeds and moving them into double figures at 10 points to 2. Auckland Warriors player of the year last year. Seem to be intent on slowing the game down. They've thrown one or two high shots. McDermott, who's on the bench, is coming back from his suspension for what he did to Peter Shields in the Challenge Cup. Peter Shields looked like he'd been in with Mike Tyson and Lennox Lewis at the same time. But they've still got the likes of Fleury and Farrell who can throw them when they want to. Of course, the problem with that is if the referee doesn't put a stamp on it early in the game, it's likely to erupt. Harris successful with his second conversion. And the Leeds Rhinos now lead the Halifax Blue Sox 12 points to 2. Halifax Blue Sox yet to see any of the possession. And when they do, Leeds are up very quickly with the tackling. Halifax struggling to get into that fluent game that they've played so well for the last 4 weeks. But you can't do it if you haven't got the football. Andy A brings it back almost to the 20. Mears again from acting half. Ducked down then and nobody near him. Well, Halifax need to keep an eye on Mears. May have been a slow start of this season. Sinfield goes through, gets the ball away to Cummins. This will be another try to Leeds, will it? Clint can't keep hold of the shot. And Cummins will score the third for Leeds. Mears that set it up, the score of the second Leeds try, and coming, finishing it off with his second of the evening. Clinch made a desperate dive. So yes, Dinaris with a simple shot what should be for him to increase the lead to 18 points to 2 after 18 minutes. Well, they've had plenty of possession and the score will is reflective of that. Halifax holding the inquest behind the post. They're smoothing in on the gantry. Down to the he's down to the skin now, gone past the nails. Harris puts over another 2 points. It's 18 points to 2 to the lead Rhinos. Well, this is going to be a long night for Halifax at the Shay. If they can't get the possession, they can't be expected to do anything. They still need to do the work in defence, but when the other team has so much possession, it's difficult to tackle for 80 minutes. Here comes Andy A out to Sinfield. Sinfield brought down just short of the 20. Mears from in half to Fleary. Fleary tackled by Donlan and Gannon. Matthew into a two-man tackle. Again Donlan, this time with McMenemy. Carl Pratt, Halifax moving up quickly. Fleary gives it back to Pratt. And there's chances on that far side. Andy A gives it to Senior. Senior to Marcus Saint-Hilaire. And Marcus Saint-Hilaire's found a gap. Problems here for Halifax again. Slip through Cardiff's tackle, but Davison does well to drag him down. But they're back on the line again. I think Davison threw one then. Getting a bit frustrated. Harris, the long ball out wide to Andy A. Numbers on the far side. Senior brought down 2 metres away from the Halifax line. Last tackle, but no good to Halifax. Still defending. Little chip through. That one will go dead. And I think Paul Davidson might be getting a little bit frustrated. McMenemy making good yards for the Blue Sox. Disappearing under three. Gannon to Lawford. Lawford shouldered by Carroll. Then all wrapped up. And Leeds are caught offside again. Lynch just making 10 with a kick. Halifax still a long way from that Leeds line. Penkovic to Gannon. Penkovic takes the return pass. And then Carroll and Farrell upenty on Penkovic. Goldspink, not the best of passers. Clinch out to Davidson. Davidson a lame pass. Halifax do well to recover. Penkovic on for Lawless. Lawford away from Sinfield. Lawford trying to create something against his former teammates, but it ends with a two-man tackle. Goldspink charging the ball up for Halifax, comes loose, went backwards, says the referee, and then there's another penalty to Halifax as the ball is reaped out in a two-man tackle. Clinch wants to get on and take the quick one. Moana away from one, charging into the Leeds defence, then upended. That must be an illegal tackle. Carl Pratt and Yestin Harris, and Moana takes exception to it, not surprisingly. Well, it's an illegal tackle and must be punished as such. Not the biggest of men, Pratt and Harris. Certainly not as big as Moana, and they turned him up and dropped him on his on the back of his neck. Well, Penkovic, being so small, was lucky to get out of one like that only moments ago. And as usual, the referees bottled it, saw the two players who committed the offence, but has put it on report as Gannon charges up to the line. Clinch to Davidson. Davidson charging to the Leeds line. Nearest Halifax have been so far in this game with ball in hand. Clinch, long ball out wide. Lawford goes for it, knocks it on. Leeds will come up with a possession. Halifax waste a chance, but they were losing ground. Bradley Clyde on for Leeds. This could add to Halifax's woe if they allow him to get into his stride. Fleury is keeping his feet, I think, in an attempt to try and wiggle out and pass the ball, or alternatively get the penalty. Matthew on halfway. Mears again, ducking under. Not making the ground this time, though. Goldspink bringing him down. Farrell standing with the ball. Halifax moving in numbers, last tackle. McDermott's on for Matthew. See how long Barry McDermott can stop on for. Yestin Harris stops one over the top. Tester for Marnes behind his own line. Diffuses the bomb. Halifax looking to play it quickly. Penkovic to McMenemy. Fleury surely obstructing McMenemy there. That'll be another penalty. Well, surely that's a professional foul, so the man must go to the sin bin. Cardis tries his hand. Caught by McDermott and Bradley Clyde just shy of halfway. Davidson off the short ball, going really from a standing start then, Paul Davidson. Clinch to Gannon, did well to take it, and looked to release it to Lawford, who I think expected the pass. McMenemy running straight at Carl Pratt, who's still in an offside position, but not gaining any advantage as Farrell and McDermott bring him down. Lawford, good ball out to Danny Tickle. Tickle will bring Marnes on the inside. How much room has Marnes got? As much as he wants, as a gap opens up, and Marnes will go down to the right-hand side of the post. Well, the Leeds defence opened up. Ollie Marnes needed some room, and the Leeds defence gave it him, and he skipped through to score Halifax's first try. They've not spent much time bound by that Leeds line, haven't Halifax? But good reward for Marnes there. Tickle knew he wouldn't make it to the lines. Marnes came on the inside, and a weaving run which took him into open space to the right-hand side of the post, and a try that the Blue Sox badly needed. Expect Danny Tickle, after kicking a 40 metre penalty earlier, to get this one, which he does do. Still leaves the Blue Sox 10 points behind, but it'll give them heart. 27 minutes gone, Leeds Rhinos 18, Halifax Blue Sox 8. Harris opts for the kick on the fork. Clinch gives it to Davidson, and Davidson brings it 15 metres away from the Blue Sox line. Gannon, almost from a standing position again, gets to the 20. Halifax forwards, well, Goldspink an exception, running with some purpose, and running when he took the ball as well. Not down yet. Fleury and Clyde will have another go on the big prop. Penkovic to Lawford. Lawford hit by Carroll, gets it away to Donlan, who can't find any room. Harris quickly onto him. Gibson from acting half into Calderwood and Pratt. Penkovic screaming for the quick play. Clinch with a dummy. Chips over the top. Could collect his own kick. Now there's chances. Just couldn't get the pass away. Martin Mohan had already set off on the run, but had to wait until Clinch went for the ball. Andy Hobson on for the Halifax Blue Sox. McDermott stepping through Hobson's tackle. Hobson on for Goldspink. As Senior comes up with a mistake, Halifax have a man down. And it looks like it might be Gavin Clinch, as Marnes tries to find a way down the middle. but can't. And it looks as though Gavin Clinch has taken a big knock as he went into Key Senior. This is worrying for Halifax. We've got Clint into a sitting position. And the magic's worked again as Clint rises to his feet. Can continue with Hobson running at Carl Pratt and Yestin Harris. Penkovic up quickly from acting half, bouncing off Yestin Harris, taking Halifax forward in important yards towards that Leeds line with Fleury all over him. Lawford in at acting half. Clinch out to Moana, bringing Tickle back on the inside. Halifax pushing forward, but perhaps not far enough. Leeds moving out very quickly. Clinch to Lawford. Lawford brings McMenemy back on the inside. McMenemy thought about the pass. Last tackle. Clinch will go to the air. Well, it's dropping in a nice spot with pressure on Cummins. And the ball loose. It's going to be a drop out under the post. So pressure on that Leeds defence from the first high kick. Has forced a drop out under the post. The half hour, Leeds Rhinos 18, Halifax Blue Sox 8. Instructions going down to Shay McMenemy from the coaching staff up on the gantry. And many yards made from the dropout as Davidson goes at full steam into the Leeds defence and brushes two away. Bradley Clyde, the man that came up after the tackle was made as Moana disappears. Well, there's all sorts of slowing down going on to play the ball from Mears and Fleury. Lawford misses out McMenemy. It's picked up by Gibson, who drifts back in field. And then he's upended by Fleury and McDermott. McMenemy must have been going as a dummy runner. Hobson did well to keep hold of that one from Clinch. Bradley Clyde. Fleury went in with as a third man after Sinfield and Clyde had gone in. Clinch. Halifax lose possession. Lost the plot there. Knock on will be given. First knock on. Leeds ball. Well, twice Halifax have lost the ball early in the tackle count going towards that Leeds line. Now they'll have to watch Harris. And they do. That's good tackling from Lawford and Donlan. Calderwood will pick it up and go from acting half. Only sideways though. Hobson misses him. Moana and Davidson done. On the 40. Bradley Clyde. Clinch takes the ball off him. Good play from Gavin Clinch. Well, he may be a superstar, but ball comes out just as easy. When Clinch goes in for it, I'll see him to off any player. Mears all over Penkovic. Now McMenemy into Mears again. Three Leeds tacklers, Fleury and Farrell were also there. Lawford brings Moana back on the inside. Moana unable to find the space in the Leeds defence. Clinch. Little chip through for Cardiff to chase, but it's picked up by Robbie Mears, who's been industrious for Leeds tonight. Scored one for Leeds and made one. Yestin threatens the long pass, then gives the bullet to Sinfield. But Halifax defence get across. Sinfield, I think, claiming for the penalty there as Clyde runs it up for the Rhinos again. Now McDermott into Clinch, who managed to slow him down. And there's a whole posse of Halifax players around Barry McDermott as he falls to the ground. Fleary driving forward. Davidson and Penkovic making the tackle. Last one of this set. Sinfield drops one out of the hands, and Marnes will take it cleanly behind the line. And he'll want the quick play again, will Marnes. But it's gone to McMenemy instead. And McMenemy's not even, well, he has now, he's made 10 metres, but he hadn't when he was stopped by the first Leeds defence. Gannon to Lawford. Lawford to Donlan. Carroll in with Harris. Lawford again to Cardis. And Cardis nowhere to go. Benkovic to Davidson. Davidson charging forward. Basketball pass over the top. Cardis looking for a gap and not finding one again. Halifax not alert, although Davidson does tend to try and release the ball every opportunity he gets, as Clint floats one out to Danny Tickle, who's brought down 22 metres away from the Leeds line. So will Clint threaten? Well, Clint won't threaten the line again, as Marnes chases and Cummins is forced to take it touching goal. Good kick from Danny Tickle to that bottom corner. Or Penkovic, I think it was. To put the pressure on Leeds, providing Halifax can keep hold of the ball. 5 minutes to go to the end of the first half, plus anything that's added on. And after roaring into an 18-point lead after 18 minutes, Halifax have... Or an 18 points to 2 lead. Halifax have got into this game a little bit. We could do with a try before half time. Here's Halifax's only try scorer so far, Marnes. And Cummins just beating him to that last kick through from Penkovic. Lawford, dummies, tries to hold off Fleary. Gets the pass away to McMenemy. He does well because he's drawn two defenders in. McMenemy gets it away to Moana. All sorts going on there, but there's going to be a forward pass. A bit of a mix-up in the middle of the field between Penkovic and Moana. And Halifax lose it again early in the tackle count near the Leeds line. Well, they do the hard work to get there and then give the possession away. The penalties have gone in Halifax's favour, 4-2. Penkovic almost having one against the head there. The senior rushes off Danny Tickle. Then goes on a long striding run on that far side and manages to regain his feet to make another 10 metres for the Leeds Rhinos. Now centre-late against Marnes. Hobson coming in. Well, Alaire's only down on one knee. Justin Harris puts the Leeds Rhinos in a good position again on the Halifax 20. McDermott into Hobson. Hobson hanging on and hanging on till the reinforcements get there. But Halifax have three in defence, so what will they in the tackle? What are the options in defence as Leeds line up? Knock on, it looked like a knock on from Mears. Harris throws it out wide to centre late. Shouts a forward pass, ball comes loose. Knock on, says the referee, as Francis Cummins trying to claim six more tackles. So Halifax will breathe a sigh of relief, looking to hold out at 18 points to 8 till half time, when they looked as though they may be pushing the Leeds line in the last 5 or 6 minutes, but spilling up possession a couple of times early in the tackle count hasn't helped the Blue Sox cause. Now they'll have to do it the hard way from inside their own, well, just outside their own tent, courtesy of the run from McMenemy. Cardis from acting half, making another tent. Now Gibson trying to step, going back inside, running to Pratt and Mears. Halifax struggling to make yards. Andy Hobson wrestling with Senior and Sinfield finally going down 8 metres from halfway. Clinch, drop-off ball to Davidson. Had Cardis on his inside, couldn't get the pass away. So Clinch will have to kick. And he does down behind Calderwood. Good kick by Clinch, putting Leeds back into their own danger area. But of course they'll get the ball from the scrum. And Halifax could do with Leeds coming up with a mistake. They'll try and put the pressure on them, sure. But Leeds can be potent from their own quarter. As Mears proved earlier when he set Cummins up for his try. Andy A off the short ball. Gives it to Sinfield. And Sinfield make good yards for Leeds up towards the 40. And Davidson penalised. Well, if he's penalising Halifax for lying on, he's got to look at both teams. Well, he's having a word with Martin Moana, Halifax captain. But there's two teams. Have a bit of consistency. As Harris again launches Leeds into a good position. 25 metres away, McDermott charging. Takes Halifax back into their own quarter. Now Bradley Clyde. Clyde taken down 6 metres away from the Halifax line, but the signs looking a bit ominous after the runs from McDermott and Clyde have made big yards for Leeds. Harris brings Farrell back on the inside. And Farrell is forced back by three. Halifax still have three to defend. Mears out to Andy A. Andy A towards the corner. And he was knocked off balance. And try to get up and say he wasn't tackled, I think. Mears fading for the kick. Ragged down by the collar from Gannon. Carl Pratt to Sinfield. And Sinfield will aim one across towards Calderwood, who's under pressure, tries to get rid of the ball. And does so in Halifax's favour. Donlan up from acting half, and Carroll, the screams of offside there as Tony Carroll went in. Halifax trying to bring it away. Good yards from Gibson. Now Andy Hobson. Saw McDermott and instinctively put his head down, I think, then. McMenemy to Davidson. Playing time added on in the first half. Last tackle. And Carl Pratt is about 3 weeks offside there. Lawford managed to lose him. But Carl Pratt went yards offside there. The referee never spotted it. But he's pulled Moana for tell his team not to lean on. I don't see him doing it to the Leeds side, who tried to slow play down in the first half. Leeds went into the lead with a try from Cummins and a conversion from Harris. And then a reply from Tickle made it 6-2 to the Leeds Rhinos. Then Mears went under himself and supplied Cummins for the next Leeds try, 3 in the first half. Harris successful with all three conversions. Halifax it back with a try from Marnes when the Leeds defence opened up to let him through. Converted by Tickle. Halifax by no means out of it half-time at this year. It's the Halifax Blue Sox 8, the Leeds Rhinos 18. The second half, and Leeds kicking off the second half and looking in the first half as though they're on the first the way to the first ever victory at the Shay. Super League 7, so it's taken a while coming, although there's another 40 minutes to go. I don't think Steve Lanaine will have told Halifax to keep hold of the ball more. Not that they could in the first 23 minutes of that first half. Gannon out to Lawford, good ball. Harris, did it touch him? Six more to the Blue Sox. And Gibson running from acting half again. McMenemy drives the ball up over halfway for the Blue Sox. Clinch, Davison the dummy run around the back to Moana. Moana to Tickle. Tickle brings Marnes back on the inside. And Marnes finding nowhere to go. Clinch out to Lawford. Did well to keep hold of it. I'm not sure whether it's actually meant for him. He's not on his feet yet. Now he's played it. He's not off his feet yet. Now he's played it. Clinch puts pressure on Saint-Hilaire as Marnes goes for it, but the ball goes into touch. Good kicking again from Clinch. Halifax needing to defend now to try and keep Leeds in their own half of the field. Penalties rounded up in the first half at 4 to the Blue Sox, 4 to the Rhinos. Sinfield out to Tony Carroll, who, given the chance, can plunder most defences. Cardis went in bravely and taken one for his troubles. And Halifax having trouble bringing Bradley Clyde down as he makes it almost up to halfway. Now Farrell making another 12 metres in the Leeds cause towards the Halifax line. Pratt to McDermott, met by Davidson, Moana and Gannon. Leeds move it back to the right. Sinfield drop off ball for Clyde. Again he's causing problems and he looked to release as well but couldn't get the ball away. Halifax now need to defend on this last tackle as Mears kicks through and might be the first man to it. But the ball is punched dead. Halifax forced to drop out under the post. So Leeds will get the pressure again. Halifax had to defend furiously in the first 23 minutes of that first half when Leeds ran in three tries. And now they must do it again at the beginning of the second half. Saint-Hilaire takes it off the bounce. Steps and tries to get away from Davidson. Wrestled to the ground with Moana there as well. Andy A. Route one up the middle. Andy Hobson back from injury, looking just his old self yet. As Harris has managed to slip the ball out, he's drawn in three tacklers, so there's chances here for Leeds as McDermott unloads. And the ball goes backwards to Calderwoods as a 3-on-2. A senior takes it and the trial will be on for Leeds here. A senior squeezes in at the corner and Halifax are left struggling in defence again as Clint complains to the referee about something. But Halifax were left wanting as the ball came out there. There were three Halifax defenders sucked into the tackle. Halifax always left wanting on this side and a long pass to Lee, to Keith Senior and the Rhinos. As they did in the first half, early scores. Point lead to the Leeds Rhinos now at 22-8. With a kick to come from Harris. But Halifax were always struggling in defence there as the ball came out of a tackle with three men from Sinfield, I think it was. And Leeds had the 3-2 on this side and Senior with the strength to get over in the corner or near enough. And leave Yestin Harris a difficult kick. Lawless warming up on the touchline, the other side of the field. Harris, as he does, taking a long time. But the Leeds supporters won't mind if that's the result. And Harris's fourth conversion to the fourth try, 100% record, 24 points to 8 for the Leeds Rhinos. And it looks like Gavin Clinch is leaving the field. And the ball kicks straight out on the full, will give Leeds another penalty. So Halifax could be staring down the barrel again here. Well, no sign of Adam Hughes, no sign of Jamie Bloom yet. And Steve Linnane has decided to stop on the side of the field, at the other side of the ground near the players' bench, as Yestin Harris puts Leeds in another good position. McDermott, Halifax defence out to meet him very quickly. Carl Pratt, Halifax defence move out again as Bradley Clyde tries to cause trouble and again tries to turn around so he can release the pass. Davidson and Hobson slowing down the play. Harris out to Senior. Senior cutting back inside. Second try for Senior. Running right down this side. Danny Tickle having trouble keeping hold of the big lead centre. Struggling to contain Senior as he did Cummings in the first half. Two tries for the big centre. Another difficult kick for Harris, although the one from a similar position, this one perhaps a little bit further in, if anything. Taking his time again, and another 2 points for Yestin Harris, and the Leeds Rhinos look to be in a strong position now, but 30 points away, 5 tries, 5 conversions. But Danny Tickle struggling in defence against Keith Senior, McMenemy. This one won't go out on the full. Fleury takes it behind his own line. Test the character for Halifax now, as Davidson's pushed away by Fleury. Well, Halifax without Gavin Clinch, for whatever reason, he walked off the field, unless he's troubled by the knee that blew up over the weekend. McDermott can't keep hold of the ball. Referee takes one on the head, as Leeds tried to kick through and play it on. Penkovic at scrum half, out to Lawford. Lawford slips Cummins, but not Sinfield and Clyde. Lawless back on, obviously for Clinch. To Gannon, who's gang tackled by 3 Leeds Rhinos defenders. Hobson, route one down the middle, tries to get the pass away. Cardis just couldn't take it. Well, not the best night for Halifax, and Bradley Clyde picks it up for Leeds. And Halifax have lost far too much possession in key areas of the field. And again, it's early in the tackle count as Carroll tries to unleash his power down that right-hand side. Good tackling from Donlan. Donlan following and tackling again on Calderwood. McDermott off the short ball. Donlan no match for McDermott, although he's hanging on round the legs while the reinforcements get there. We'll have to get back in defence quickly. Harris down the middle, gets the ball away to Carl Pratt. Well, that'd be another look to see if it were forward. Now there's a chance on that far side. Pratt throws it back inside, but the pass was forward. And Leeds running out at the moment. And look as though this could be a big score in their favour. Halifax struggling in the three quarters. Leeds pulled for offside by Ian Smith. And a big kick into touch. Goes in on the 40. Halifax want to get on and play it quickly. And Leeds were, I think, on the 9.5 metre mark there. Lawless to McMenemy. McMenemy, good ball to Hobson. Shouldered by Andy Ado. Big hit from the Leeds second rower on Andy Hobson. Lawford to Moana. Moana pops it up nicely for Danny Tickle. But Tickle unable to create the opening. Senior all over him. Halifax get another penalty. Halifax quick to take it. Lawford turns it back to Lawless. Lawless to Donlan. It's Donlan. And he's brought down 5 metres away from the Leeds line. Lawless. Lawford in it though, but a lot of things for Halifax. As is McMenemy. Cardis. He'll find the gap. Will Cardis will it? He's turned over. Hasn't got it down though. Lawless quickly from Acton half. He'll get it down. Halifax needed a quick reply, and they've got one from John Lawless. A big gap there for Cardis, but the Leeds defence managed to herd him into the post, and he just couldn't get the ball down. Lawless reaching over, puts it down, Tickle in front of the post. And that's so Danny Tickle, his third conversion of the evening, makes it 30 points to 14. That might give Halifax a bit of hope. Two tries and two conversions from Leeds already. Halifax getting a quick reply. And still plenty of time to go. But Leeds seem to have the strength in depth. Davidson trying to stop it with his feet. Well, a sensible thing to do. Might have knocked it on had he gone for it with his hands. But normally that spot would have been filled by Gavin Clint. So it puts Halifax immediately back under pressure. So all that work they've done to score the try could be undone. As McMenemy finds Andy A just inside the Leeds half. Met by Davidson and Moana. Ball comes loose. Given a knock on. So Davidson making up for that mix-up behind the line. Andy A. The ball squeezed out of his grasp by Davidson's tackle. Moana there as well, of course. But the ball had gone by the time Moana had got there, I think. Lawford. Round the back to Donlan. Who's clattered by Tony Carroll. So Halifax again lose it early in the tackle count. And have to defend again. Farrell. Trying to duck underneath. Now it's the Leeds Rhinos' turn to shout for the offside. Bradley Clyde trying to go through. Good tackling. Somebody going down late there. With a flop, so Harris will take the 2 points in front of goal. this will be Yestin Harris's sixth conversion, and will give Leeds an 18-point cushion, which wouldn't have been so had the ball not being given away again early in the tackle count. So 32-14, and Jamie Bloom enters the fray. Still no sign of Adam Hughes. Dean Lawford leaving the field, so that's Halifax losing the two main halfbacks. And Bloom drops one right down on the Leeds try line, but Sinfield seems to have acres of space in which to run it out, and makes good yards 15 metres away from the Leeds line. Jamie Matthews back on. Swap for Andy Hay, who made that mistake. And Matthew immediately unleashes McDermott. And McDermott trying to pump the legs. And Moana and Hobson both having trouble putting him down. Eventually the ball's played as Harris kicks over the top. Davidson, well, I don't know if it came off him or he played the man, but he's chasing Cummins, and Cummins has got away, and Cummins is still going. Well, Ian Smith hasn't wiped the tackle count, but Jim Gannon has given Leeds an opportunity again as Harris takes the quick tap. Leeds keen to get on with it. Halifax, their own worst enemies in giving away penalties and losing possession. Sinfield brings Senior on the inside, looking for a hat trick as he's Cummins in the Leeds Rhinos colours. Mears, huge gap opening up for Robbie Mears, and the Leeds supporters thought he'd scored. It was Donald who managed to hang on to him, but Leeds have men stacked on that far side. Tony Carroll has managed to get it away to Calderwood, and Calderwood is added to the ground, and it's picked up, I think, by Gibson on the far side. The ball goes into touch, but there's no advantage. He's given a penalty anyway. And McMenemy makes a few more grateful yards away from that Halifax line. Halifax putting themselves under pressure, not only by losing the ball, but giving away far too many penalties. Here comes Hobson. Lawless from acting half, trying to create an opening. They're making good yards into Leeds territory. But Menemina acting half out to Gannon. And Gannon almost wriggles free from Bradley Clyde. Bloom out to Davidson. Bloom signalling the kick on the last tackle. And I think every Leeds player will have seen that one. So they're going to converge on Bloom, who manages to get his crossfield kick in, but goes straight out on the full at the far side of the field. So not the best of nights for the Blue Sox, not having the rub of the green, but not able to defend against this constant Leeds onslaught, especially from Key Senior down this side in the second half. And Mears, who's been a thorn in Halifax's side. Moana hurt himself as he went down. Gannon, Maytew and Matthew stayed down. Tony Carroll off down that far side again. He's been well marked so far this evening. Farrell stepping back into trouble on the far side. Harris fires that one to Pratt. Looks as though Bloom thought about the interception then. Just pulling Davidson away as Harris chips over the top, forcing Cardis back. Too much weight behind that one. The ball's over the dead ball line. But most of this, the opening minutes of this second half played as they were in the first in Halifax half of the field. as Cannon drives the ball up to Halifax towards the 40. Lawless to McMenemy. Bloom. Followed all the way by Sinfield. Must be a penalty, it's missing about the play of the ball. Lawless to Davidson, who shrugs off three and then gets it back, but it's a loose pass picked up by, well, not picked up by Moana, he's managed to knock it on. And again, Halifax lose possession. Absolute mountain of errors tonight for the Blue Sox. Carl Pratt out to Harris. Harris to, on the floor to Tony Carroll. Carroll away to Calderwood. He has pace as Calderwood. Will they catch him? Throws the ball back inside. Great tackling on the far side. Good chasing by Cardis, I think it was. So Leeds surrender possession early in the tackle count, but as a result of some ambitious rugby trying to catch Halifax on the flanks again. And Darren Fleary's moved to stand off for the Leeds Rhinos to counter the threat of that man McMenemy. Tickle clattered by Senior. Bloom, great ball to Penkovic. Penkovic has beaten Cummins, but Harris spins Penkovic round. Penkovic tries to get it played quickly. Harris pulled him down again. Lawless to Bloom. Bloom towards that Leeds line. Bloom still going. And eventually put down by three. Played quickly. Lawless out to Moana. Good ball to Davidson. Davidson towards the line. This is a try for Halifax. Great try from Paul Davidson. Davidson still had the work to do with two defenders there, and he's brushed them out of the way on his way to the line, but Penkovic's initial burst was the key to that Halifax try being set up. Danny Tickle also keeps his 100% record with 4 from 4. Well, the league cut to 12 points. Is it too late for a dramatic comeback by Halifax? He managed to keep hold of the ball long enough there for Davidson to plough his way over that Leeds line. And they'll be careful with this one. Gannon picks it up. And McDermott waits with the shoulder. And Fleary with the tackle. Farrell with the tackle, sorry. Bloom onto McMenemy. Penalty to Halifax. McMenemy quick to get on with it and dispatch the ball into touch at the far side as Carl Pratt pleads his innocence. Goldspink running this time from depth. Lawless to Gannon. Gannon unloading untidily, but Gibson picks it up, gives it to Moana. Halifax are losing ground as Moana tries to make it back under the tackle of Mears and Clyde. Lawless, here goes Davidson again, and Davidson pops the ball up. Lawless gets it. Well, he knocked it on then, John Lawless managed to get away with it. Said something naughty went on though, as Bloom fires it away to Gannon, then goes for the return. Bloom round the outside, then cuts back inside into three. McMenemy, good ball out the back door to Gannon. Gannon gets it away to Lawless. Lawless gets it away. Halifax on the last tackle. They could have done with a quick play there. They're not going to get it. Davidson from short again. Lawless, long pass out. Could have Leeds out. Moana to Gibson. Gibson stepping inside and Gibson's going to get caught. Shovels it out the back. Halifax lose ground. Cardiff to pick it up, then loses it. And Leeds are 35 metres away from their own line when the last tackle. Perhaps Gibson might have gone down with it. Furiously try to keep it alive. Desperate stuff from the Blue Sox. But the question now is, have Halifax enough left to do it in defence as Leeds attack again? With the lead cut to 12 points, now they're relying on Tony Carroll again. Farrell down the middle. Caught on the 40 by Bloom. Jamie Matthew, short ball to Bradley Clyde. Good tackling. Destin Harris holding back for the grubber, then getting the ball away. Pass has gone forward. St Hilaire thought it was in. Too far forward, a senior. Halifax held back, waiting for Destin Harris to kick. Mans, not the best of passes. Ball goes out to Gannon. Plays safety this time. Looked for somebody to pass to, decided to keep all of it. Mans will go from acting half this time, run straight at Carl Pratt, who took one in the eye as he tackled Gannon. Goldspink pumping the legs but not getting anywhere. Good tackle from Mears. Lawless from acting half. Made yards for Halifax, look for support. Back to Bloom for the kick. This one again, going straight out on the full. Not a good kicking night for Jamie Bloom. I think he might have been better to go for distance. Mike Bloom to force Leeds back and turn them round. Or maybe it was, it spiralled off the outside of the foot. Destin Harris steps one, gets away from Davidson, off towards the Halifax line, and that's what Harris can do to turn him out, straight from the back of the scrum. Destin Harris, that'll probably seal it for Leeds now. Harris will oblige with his eighth conversion, but Halifax looking a ragged side now. Leeds have run them all over the park this evening. Destin Harris kicking towards those Leeds supporters at the far end, no problem with his eighth conversion. Bloom tries the short kickoff, nothing to lose. Gannon onto it. Great take inside to Goldspink. Goldspink looks for support and finds it with Cardis. Cardis opening up down the middle. Stretching the legs, but the Leeds defence regrouping very quickly. Lawless to Penkovic. Penkovic trying to old man the Leeds defence. Getting dumped for his troubles by three. Lawless from acting half. Moana. Leeds defence are out very quickly to Moana. Gets rid of it one-handed to Davidson. Davidson squaring up with Fleury there, I think. McMenemy. Good pass away. Halifax still just short of that line. Gannon actually went for the line there. I think he'd was expecting the ball. Bloom. Bloom teasing the Leeds defence. And then managing to get the ball away to Goldspink. And Goldspink will settle it down eventually after looking for somebody to pass to. Last tackle. Moana from acting half. Chip through on the floor from Moana for Tickle to chase. It's picked up by Calderwood. And Halifax will try and take Calderwood unsuccessfully back over his own line. Cummins bringing it out for Leeds. Chev Walker, not bad replacement to bring on. England international. England international or not, Davidson still does the work on him. And I don't think Chev Walker was too impressed with that, as Fleer is hit by Lawless. Straight pass, bounces kindly as it would for Harris, who steps. McMenemy tries to pull the ball out. And it looks like Adam Hughes might finally make an appearance in this game. It'll be too late for Halifax now, though, as Leeds keep that 18-point gap. Cardis with acres of space to run in, but the Leeds defence up very quickly. Harris, Cardis stepping senior, but the numbers were there with Hilaire and Fleury. Gibson going from acting half again, but only making ground sideways. Moana into Fleury and Matthew. Now Davidson again. Sinfield went upstairs. He's not going to stop Davidson like that. And there's all sorts of messing about there from Bradley Clyde. Goldspink tries to get the ball away. Well, Halifax can't move because the Leeds defence are up that quickly. Senior off round the outside looking for his third. Adam Hughes on. Well, Steve Linnane said he could play a big part in this game. It'd have to be a very big part now for Adam Hughes in the 10 minutes or so that remains. Carl Pratt out to Harris as Carroll moved inside. Halifax marking Harris closely this time, but also keeping an eye on the support as well. As Walker throws a straight pass, and again, it's bounced kindly as Carroll is buried 10 metres away from the Halifax line. Mears ducking under again. Robbie Mears ducked under about three there. Even when he was on his knees, he was still trying to reach towards that line. Harris out the back to Walker. Walker chips it through. Try not given. Well, the in-goal touchdown and the touchdown with a flag both took up a position as if the try might have been given there. As Marnes goes from the 20 up to the 40. Fleury all over him, slowing the play down again. Gibson goes from acting half and makes it up to halfway. Lawless looking for the gap, making 8 or 9 metres. Davidson fancies a run, releases out the back. Penkovic quickly smothered man and ball. Adam Hughes to Gannon. Well, not Gannon, it's Bloom. That's Gannon. Now it's back to Bloom again. Bloom gives it to Cardis. Last tackle. McMenemy this time. Tries his hand with a boot, so to speak. But good take by Cummins. Halifax adjudged to have tackled Cummins while he was in the air. And Leeds come away with Harris again, giving it to Marcus Saint-Hilaire, who's done a lot of running but not made much ground, most of it gone sideways. Chev Walker on halfway for the Leeds Rhinos. Bradley Clyde into a three-man Halifax tackle, but gets Leeds back up to the Halifax 40. Mears allowed time to pass the ball. Halifax tackler's moving quickly though. Mears from acting half to Matthew. Halifax could be struggling on this side again. Senior cutting loose. Well, he got out of the tackle and gave it inside to Fleary. This is the last one of this set of six. Mears to Jamie Matthew. Back to Mears, who just manages to keep hold of it. And Yestin Harris is off again on one of those runs. Gives it to Senior. And he'd waited that long at Senior. I think his hands had got cold and he dropped the ball. So, Mahon's from acting half. Leeds yards offside again. Mahon's will go for the quick tap again. Leeds are still not back the 10. And Fleary comes round with one over the top. Ball comes loose. Adam Hughes, former Leeds player, of course, on two occasions. Gets it away to Gannon. Actually, player, as we recall from Wakefield, played for Leeds in a Boxing Day friendly and then went back to Wakefield. And subsequently joined Halifax. Cardis looking for a way through. Halifax looking a bit tired. At 38-20 into the last 5 minutes. Gannon. Well taken by McMenemy. Not the best of passes. Now Penkovic. Who seems to have reverted to a one-man rugby ploy. Halifax have nothing to lose by throwing it about. Davidson will take Halifax up to the Leeds 20. Bradley Clyde struggling to his feet. Chip through on the floor. Could put pressure on Calderwood. And Calderwood decided to dispatch the ball into the Halifax crowd. Hearing, obviously hearing the numbers of defenders that were chasing after him. Harris drops out to Adam Hughes, stood on the Halifax 40. Hughes eyes up the options and brings it back to the Leeds 30. Here's Halifax man of the match, Paul Davidson, shrugging off two, shrugging off three, and then disappearing under three. Lawless went for it on his own. Tackled by former Sheffield teammate Keith Senior. Penkovic out to Bloom. Bloom away to Gannon. Gannon gets it back to Bloom, and Bloom is going to score another try for the Halifax Blue Sox. And somebody went late then. Somebody went in on Bloom for the second time and also took the referee with him. Well, Halifax have managed successfully the damage limitation, because it looked at one point as though the Leeds Rhinos were absolutely going to run riot. And they stuck out of Halifax. Tickle converts his fifth goal. So 34-26, and had Halifax managed to keep hold of the 38-26, and had Halifax managed to keep hold of the ball a bit more, the score might have been a bit closer, not because they would have scored, but they would have it would have meant Leeds had a bit less possession. As it is, that 18 point gap has generally been enough. Here comes Davidson again. Sinfield goes upstairs again. Does that man not know where the legs are? McDermott there as well. Brett Goldspink into Matthew and McDermott. Driven to the floor, the ultrasounds for the end of this match. Leeds Rhinos have won the first ever game at the Shay, but it's against an inexperienced partnership of Tickle and Donlan, which was probably the key, as in the second half, Senior opened the scoring for Leeds with two tries down this left-hand side, which Harris converted, which took Leeds from the 18-8 lead into a 30-8 lead. And it looked as though Halifax might be under the cosh, it might be run ragged. But a try from Lawless by the post, converted by Tickle, gave Halifax a glimmer of hope, until Halifax conceded the penalty under the post and Leeds went ahead 32-14. Try, a storming try from Halifax man of the match, Paul Davidson, and a try from Tickle, conversion from Tickle, brought it back to 32-20. And would Halifax have enough in the last 12 minutes when they've played so well the last couple of weeks? But they seem to run out of steam. And Harris, from the back of the scrum, as he has done so often, went over to the right-hand side of the post from 30 metres out, converted his eighth kick, 100% record for Yestin Harris. Bloom hitting back with a try, Tickle with a conversion. The 18 points always enough for Leeds. Halifax got it back to 12 but ran out of time. Tickle kicked his fifth conversion after Bloom tries, but the Leeds Rhinos probably deserved winners. Going away with the two Super League points is the Halifax Blue Sox 26, Leeds Rhinos 38.
You got hold of it?
Okay. What's the rest of it? You get hold of it, but
he'll know I am. No, he'll know I am. It's happening.
Yeah, I know.